गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। माई सेल्फ मनोज कुमार बुंदेला, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर सुरेश ज्ञान विहार यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द प्रोडक्शन टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ वेजिटेबल एंड स्पाइसेस। इन दैट टूडे वी विल डिस्कस द प्रोडक्शन टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ कैबेज। कैबेज, द बोटेनिकल नेम ऑफ कैबेज इज ब्रेसिका ओलेरेसिया वेराइटी कैपिटाटा। फैमिली इज ब्रेसिकेसी। क्रोमोजोम नंबर 2n = 18। एंड एडिबल पार्ट इज हेड। इंट्रोडक्शन, तो कैबेज इज इंट्रोड्यूस फ्रॉम साउथ वेस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ यूरोप। इट इज ए मेनली इज ए नेटिव ऑफ यूरोप एंड ग्रोइंग अलोंग द कोस्ट ऑफ नॉर्दर्न सी। द एनुअल वर्ल्ड प्रोडक्शन इज 21 मिलियन टन्स ऑफ फ्रेश हेड्स फ्रॉम 1.1 मिलियन हेक्टेयर। कैबेज is cultivated in large extent in Sri Lanka, mainly in the up countries, as a round crop, means in all years, in hilly areas it is grown in all the time we can grow in hilly areas, all the years. Important economical and rotational crop in the major vegetable growing area. About the plant, the roots, so it have the advantageous root system, means it does not have the taproot system, it has a small root system, advantageous root system. Stem is unbranched stem. Leaves are arise as the growing point. The outer leaves are green in color and the inner ones are white in color. Outer leaves are green in color and inner ones are white in color. As the plant grow, the leaves increase in number, forming a bell-shaped head. The bud formed by the overlapping of numerous leaves developing over the growing point of its shorter stem. So like this, there is a leaf will develop. So you can see in diagram. So the inside leaves are white in color, outside is green in color. Varieties. Green cornet. It is a firm, light green, oval shaped up country. It is mainly grown in up country. Exotic F1. It is a medium firm, plaited round, low country and mid country. Hercules. It is a uniform, blue green, very firm, globe, up country it is mainly grown. Gloria. It is a firm, plaited globe and it is mainly grown in up country. So these are the important varieties of cabbage. Climate requirement. Temperature. It is grow best in relatively cool and humid climate in dry atmosphere. The leaves are petiolated and impaired quality of the head. Poor yield, they will give the poor yield, difficult to control the pest. The optimum temperature for growth is 18 to 20 degrees centigrade. The optimum temperature for the growth is 18 to 20 degrees centigrade temperature is best. Rainfall. The water requirements is vary from 380 to 500 mm per crop. Per crop it requires the 380 to 500 mm water. Depends on the climate and length of the growing season. So climate means in summer season if the temperature is more, so they require the more amount of water. If temperature is less, it requires the less amount of water. The crop water use increase during the growing end period of the season, means when the crop is ready for harvesting, means when the development of heads will be start, that time the require the more quantity of water. Soil requirement. Can be grown on a wide range of soils. It is grown well on well-drained soils. The moisture retention in loamy soils, well supplied with the organic matters. Not grow well in highly acidic soil. It is not grow well in highly acidic. If the soil has the more acidic condition, then it is not grow well. pH range. So the range of the pH is 5.5 to 6.5. Should not be allowed to fall below 4 to 5 degrees centigrade. Means the pH is 5.5 to 6.5 only. If the pH is less than 4 or less than 5, means more acidic soil are there. So then the head will not develop. If the pH is 6.5, the leaves become dark, but the leaf margin is dyed. So if the pH is more than 6.5, then also the leaf margin will be dyed. So this is the after transplanting in first stage of the plant, cabbage plant. Cultivation practice. So propagation, it is mainly propagated through the seeds. So for seed propagation, first we have to go for preparation of nursery bed. First we prepare the nursery bed, we show the seeds in nursery bed, then we will go to the transplanting into the main field. The soil preparation, clean the land before 8 weeks of planting. 8 weeks of planting we have to clean the land, then we will go for deep plowing. Deep plowing with the help of harrow, we will go for deep plowing. After deep plowing, we will expose the soil to the sunlight, or we will fumigate the soil for 2 weeks. So what will happen if we go for fumigation of the soil at the time of planting? So it will control the nematodes, or if there is a larvae are present of any insect larvae or any pupas, if they are present inside the soil, they will die. So for that we have to go for fumigation, and we will expose the soil to the sunlight. So planting, normally we will go for direct seedling or transplanting of seedlings. So direct seedling and transplanting of seedlings. So for that, first we go for preparation of nursery bed. So we prepare the raised nursery bed. We have to prepare 3 meter into 1 meter size raised nursery bed of 12 to 15 centimeter raised. Means the height of the bed is 12 to 15 centimeter, diameter is 1 meter, and length is 3 meter. It's recommended. The area should be spent for sunshine. Means the sunshine will be directly available to that particular area. Like that area we have to select for the preparation of nursery. This should not be cultivated Brassicaceae family crop earlier. If we grow the Brassicaceae crop family earlier, means the whatever the disease which are transferred there in that particular crop, it will be transferred to the new crop also. Soil should not be an acidic. If the soil are acidic is there, then it is not good for the plant. Apply the paddy husk or straw layer on the surface of the bed. So after, means first we prepare the nursery bed, then we prepare the line. Raised bed we prepare, then we prepare the line. In line we have to sow the seeds. After that we cover it by the husk or straw. We can use the paddy straw or husk for the 2 to 3 days. So if we cover it by the husk or that, then the inside temperature of the soil temperature will be increased. So the seed germination will be start earlier. Fire from the opposite of the wind direction to sterilize the bed. If we can go for firing, fire means attempt to increase the temperature. Apply 3 to 4 kg of organic manure we have to apply. Put seeds about 1 cm deep on the lines that maintain the 30 cm space with the line. Means when we go for sowing of the seeds, we will put the seeds in 1 cm deep lines to maintain the 10 cm space in the line. Desired size are only well hardened. The young stocky plants should be used for transplanting. So whenever we go for selection of the plant for the transplanting, so we have to select the young and healthy plant we have to select. If the plant will fall down, if there is a plant, if any attack is there in plant, then we have to not select that. Transplanting is done on moist soil and the soil are completely in wet condition. That time we will go for transplanting. In wet area are used, wet area are raised bed or ridges. It reduces the water logging and stem on all the root rot disease. It reduces the water logging and stem and root rot disease. Apply the fungicides to control the damping of and anthracnose. To control the damping of anthracnose, we will apply the fungicides. Water to the bed and mulch it by using the paddy straw. And continuously we will go for watering and we will cover it by the paddy straw. Cover the beds by using the polythenes. It should not be transplanted to avoid the sun rays and rain. Should not be transplanted to the avoid the sun rays and rain. Plant population are and spacing influence the head size, head shape and yield. The plant population is vary according to the target market for the particular crop. So according to the whatever the spacing we have to use, that spacing we have to use according to the requirement in the market in fertilizer. It required a supplementary fertilizer in the form of manure and fertilizer. Means we have to apply the manure and fertilizers, and we have to also apply the NPK. So first dose of complete dose of P and K and half dose of nitrogen we apply at a initial stage. Means during the land preparation we will apply the half dose of nitrogen and full dose of P and K we apply. And second dose of nitrogen we will apply third week after transplanting. Means after 3 weeks after transplanting, we will apply the second dose of nitrogen. Irrigation should be irrigated after sowing or transplanting. Means just after sowing and transplanting, we will go for irrigation. Irrigation interval is 10 to 12 days in heavy soils and 8 days in light soil. The interval irrigation interval is 10 to 12 days in heavy soil and 8 days in light soil. Should receive the enough water for the vegetative growth before forming the heads in your plants. Should receive the enough water for vegetative growth before forming the head in the young plants. The excess moisture causes the plant to damage leaves. If the moisture content is more, the plant will get damaged. So we have to apply the water according to the requirements of the crop. We will not apply the so much of water, we will not apply the less water, because that both will affect the yield. Weed control. It is controlled by the mechanical by hand as well as the chemical by application of herbicides. So either we can use the herbicides, means mechanically we can use, or we can go for head weeding with the help of hand. We can go for hand weeding, we can go, or we can use the chemicals, like we can apply the herbicides, we can apply to control the weeds. Next is pest control. In pest, first pest is aphid. So aphid is gray cabbage aphid and gray peach aphid. So gray cabbage aphid, aphid and gray peach aphid. It is damaged. Aphid means they will suck, they are insect, they will suck the sap from the plant and contaminate the edible product. Means they will suck the sap, means they will suck the whatever the sap is present in the leaves, and it will not edible. They will reduce the quality of the produce. It they will cause the chlorosis and make the malformation of the leaves. Second one is diamond black moth. Suck the sap from the tender growth, resulting in the whitish and scaled appearance. Next one is Bagrata bug. It is damaged if they suck the sap from the tender growth, resulting in the whitish and scaled appearance. American bollworm, Helicorpa armigera. The larva will feed on the leaves and destroy the growing point of the plant. The American bollworm, Helicorpa armigera, the larva will feed on the leaves and destroy the growing point of the plant. Cabbage webworm. So larva spins a thin web over the feeding pellets, and it will destroy the growing point of the plant. Means in the leaves only, it will go inside the leaf and start the feeding of the leaves. Greater cabbage moth. The larva spins a thin web over the feeding pellets and destroys the growing point of the plant. It is same like greater cabbage moth and web. The red spider mite. Red spider mite, it is damaged, suck and result in the bulging and yellowing. Suck and resulting in the bulging and yellowing of the leaves. Cutworm, Agrotis species. So cut off the stem of the young seedlings and close the ground level. Means it will cut the stem of the young seedlings. This is the symptoms you can see in the leaves. They will eat the leaves. The chlorophyll content will be reduced. Pulsia looper. Pulsia looper feed on the leaves and cause the damage by the cutting the foliage. Thrips. It contaminates the edible product, thus the affecting its appearance and quality. Means thrips, they will damage the edible product and it will affect the appearance and quality. Nematodes. They will cause the unthirsty and may become stunted. General control measure we can use. We can go for practice of crop rotation, because it is transmitted by aphid, means insect. So insect we can control by crop rotation, means we can grow the different crop. Like first time if we are growing the brassicaceae crop, so next season we can grow the solanaceous crop, so that the disease will not transfer from one to the another. Growing the resistant cultivar. So we can grow the cultivar which are resistant to that particular disease. Use of registered chemicals. We can use the registered chemical, we can use the neem seed kernel extract, we can use the we can to control the insect damage, we can use the sticky traps, we can use yellow sticky traps, we can use disease control, damping off, Alternaria species or the Isoctonia. So damping off is mainly occurs in the seedling stage. When we go for preparation of nursery, that time it is mainly occurs. Will affect the seedlings, turns the purple and die, and often have the no lateral roots. Control using the use the treated seeds. So whenever we go for preparation of nursery, we will use the seeds which are treated by Capron and Thyrone. Sterilize the seeded bed before planting. So before planting, we will go for sterilization, removing the infected plant when the symptoms appear. If there any symptoms will appear, we can remove the infected plants so that it will not spread. Next is Sclerotonia rot, or it is called as white mold. So it is favored by the cool and wet condition, means the temperature is low and is a wet condition. It is mainly suitable for the Sclerotonia rot. Above ground parts of infected plants may be covered with a white cottony growth. The above ground part of the plant will be look means it will develop the white cottony growths will develop. It is controlled by the we can go for crop rotation, planting on ridges or raised bed, removal and destruction of infected plant crop residues, good water management aimed at keeping the soil dry. So what is the control measure we have to use? We can go for crop rotation, remove the infected plants, and good water management. Because the wet condition are there, then it will be effective. So normally, whenever the water is required, that time only we will apply the water, so that we can manage the water and the wet condition will be not developed. Clubroot, Plasmodiphora brassica. Clubroot is a soil borne disease. The most severe on the acidic soil and moderate pH soil that are poorly drained. So clubroot is mainly it is a soil borne disease. So you can see the roots will develop like club. There is club at one place, the roots. Stunting, wilting, and purpling of the leaves. So leaves means the whatever the nutrients and water, it will not reach to the leaves. So the leaves will start purpling and the wilting of the plants will develop. Because the nutrient is not available, then the plant will start wilting. Control by practice the sanitation. Normally we will go for sanitation. Practicing the crop rotation. Grow the transplant in the fumigated bed. First we go for fumigation of bed, then we go for transplanting. Lime the soil. So we can apply the lime in the soil because it is mainly occurs in more acidic soil. So if we add the soil lime in the soil, the acidity will be reduced. Fusarium wilt for cabbage yellow. Fusarium oxysporum variety congulatinis. The symptoms, the yellow foliage often mainly on the one side of the plant. So the foliage color will be start yellowing, the leaves become distorted and gradually turns brown or drop prematurely. The leaves will start dropping of the leaves will be start, and discoloration of vascular area. The vascular area of the leaves will be start discoloration. These are the symptoms of Fusarium wilt. So you can see the symptoms of Fusarium wilt. The yellowing of the leaves will start, discoloration of the leaves will be start. So you can see like this. So discoloration will be start, the photosynthesis will be effect. By planting the resistance cultivars, growing the cabbage in winter. If we grow in winter, means it is not exposed to the sunlight. The planting on soil free from the disease. Soil fumigation we can go before planting. Practicing the crop rotation, we can go for crop rotation. And practicing the sanitization. It is black leg. So black leg is a seed borne disease. White or light brown lesions with a purple to black margin develop on the stem and on the leaves. White and light brown lesions with a purple to black margin will develop on the stem and the leaves. Control, to control the use the control size seedling, means the seedling we have to keep from the black log, means treated seedlings we have to use. Fungicide treatment of the seeded bed. Seed bed we have to go for fungicide treatment. Seed bed should be situated far from the old production field. So whatever the seed bed we prepare, it is far from the production field. The seed bed should be destroyed if the leaf lesions are found. if the leaf lesions are found, then we have to go for destruction of the seed bed because it is spread very fast. Bacterial leaf spot. It is mainly caused by the Pseudomonas. The symptoms severe in the cool and moist weather condition. Symptoms the small tanked water soaked area on the underside of the leaves. It will develop a small tanked water soaked area on the underside of the leaves. The affected area develop into brownish to purplish gray necrotic spots. Brownish to purplish gray necrotic spots. Fairly irregular after a few days. Starting with this purplish to gray necrotic spots. After that, if you are control. Do chemical control, plant the tolerant or resistant cultivar we can plant, use the disease-free seeds or seed treated with the hot water. Normally we will use the disease-free seeds. Control this. Harvesting maturity. Crop is harvested when the heads are attained their full size. When the head size is full, that time we will go for harvesting. A fully developed head has a lighter shade of green. So fully mature heads we have to harvest and it has a lighter shade of green. So that type head we have to go for harvesting. So harvesting method, normally with the help of knife, we will cut the head. So we will use them like this, he is using the knife. So with the help of knife, we will just cut the heads. Post-harvest handling. So harvested parts, remove from the direct sunlight and transported to the packing shed as soon as possible. Means just after harvesting, what we have to do, we will not keep the head in sunlight and we will pack it and transplant into the and sell transported into the market. Sorting and grading. The injured leaves should be removed. If the outer leaves, some leaves are injured, then that leaves we have to remove. Packing. Packed in plastic bucket. So normally the heads are packed into the plastic packet and wrapped with the polythene. So like this, they will keep into plastic packet and they will wrapped by the polythene. So it will increase the lifespan of the heads. Then we can store it for the longer period of the time. Store under the low temperature. The relative humidity is 90 to 95%. Temperature is low, relative humidity is 90 to 95%. Remove the discolored but upon the removal of the from the storage, the discolored and if there is affected by the any disease, that we have to remove. So like this we have to store in polythene. Transport. Use truck for transportation. We can use the trucks. Trucks should be overloaded, should not be overloaded on the bottom layer of the produce or crust. So normally when we go for transportation, it will be not overloaded. If the overloaded is there, then the lower portion, whatever the cabbage heads are there, they will get damaged. So it will be, they will get crushed. So normally it will be not overloaded. Next is usage. The whole plant can be consumed cooked and raw as a slab. Means complete plant we can use. We can use as a cooked or we can use as a slab. Medicinal value. It will prevent the bladder, stomach and lung cancer. Prevent the stomach pain. It will prevent the stomach pain. Prevent the stomach and intestinal ulcer. It will prevent the stomach and intestinal ulcer. Reduce the excess stomach acid. So it is very good. This cabbage is very good for the stomach. These are the different products. Like we can prepare the cabbage juice. We can prepare from cabbage salads. We can use and for the. These are the different products. Post harvest product we can prepare from the cabbage leaves. So this is all about the cabbage. Thank you for your attention. Thank you. Good morning to all. Myself, Manoj Kumar Bundela, Assistant Professor, Suresh Gyan Vihar University, Jaipur. So we will discussing about the production technology of vegetable and spices. So today we will start with cluster bean. So cluster bean, the scientific name of cluster bean is Phymopsis tetragonolobus. Chromosome number 2N is equal to 2X is equal to 14. And the origin palace of cluster bean is different. Means it is still not confirmed where is the correct origin palace of cluster bean. The dry region of West Africa as well as India are treated as the center of origin of cluster bean by the various workers. So it is originated from India also and the dry region of West Africa. The ancestor of cluster bean is Synopsis seneglensis. So Synopsis seneglensis, it is a ancestor of cluster bean tetragonolobus. Means cluster bean tetragonolobus developed from this. The cluster bean is drought-tolerant, warm-season annual legume, crop grown for its tender fruits for use as a vegetable. So it is mainly grown for the tender fruits. The cluster bean is also known as guar, guarfili. We can say it is a guarfili also we can say. Guar or guarfili, botany. Cluster is an upright, erect, summer annual growing to a height of 3 meter with stiff erect branches. So it is a summer annual growing, the height is 3 meter, stiff erect branches. Stem is angled, leaves are trifoliate, flowers are small white or purple color. Androecium is monodelphous, it has a 10 stamens. The inflorescence is axillary raceme. The fruits are compressed, erect and 4 to 10 cm long, double ridge on the dorsal side, single ridge below. The fruits are normally 4 to 10 cm long. It has a two ridges, double ridges and single ridges. The seeds are 5 to 10, white to gray or black colored seeds per fruits. The infant fruits, there is a 5 to 12 seeds are there. The color of the seed is white color or it is in black color. The root system, it has a deep root system. The beans are large. Beans have the large endosperm. The endosperm contains the large amount of gum, which is marketable product of the plant. So normally we will extract the gum from this and that gum is the marketable product. We can sell it into the market. So plant, so we can see the cluster bean plant. This is the flowers, this is the fruits, and these are the seeds of cluster bean or guarfili. Uses, used as a vegetable as a tender stage in sorghum parts of India. They are dehydrated in southern part of India and they are dehydrated and stored for the use. So mucilaginous seed floor is used for making the gum. So it has the mucilaginous seed floor that is used for the preparation of gum, which is used in textile, paper, cosmetic and oil industries. The gum of guar from hydrates rapidly in water into a viscous gel and is therefore used in the various products. It will prepare the different products we can prepare. No calories binding agent, not require any calorie binding agent. It is pharmaceutical industries. The gum is used into the pharmaceutical industries. In cloth and paper manufacturing industries, it is used. Oil, it is a well drilling used as a absorbent for the explosive. It is also used as absorbent for the explosives. Used for the forage, green manure. It is also used for the green manure. Also used for the soil improvement as a medicine. It is also used for the soil improvement as a medicine. So this is the gum and this is a gum powder and their uses. Nutrient composition. The fruits are rich in food value and each 100 gram of fruits contain fat 81 gram, minerals 10.8 gram, vitamins 3.2 milligram, vitamin C 0.4 milligram, riboflavin 1.4 gram, thiamine 316 international unit. And it is also a source of iron. The iron content is 47 milligram. It contains the 47 milligram. Guar meal, it means dry seeds. Guar meal, the dry seeds contain 0.33% of protein. It contains the 33% of protein. Galactomenon is a polysaccharide and constitutes 68 to 705 polysaccharides, also known as guar gum. The galactopyrons or the menopyrons units form the galactomenon. The young plants contain the hydrolic acid, which is toxic to the animals. So harvesting of forage is done from flowering to the fruiting stage. So when we go for harvesting of forage, normally at the time of flowering to the fruiting stage we will go. Cluster bean benefit. The benefit, it is mainly used for the diabetes, stronger bones, it will strong the bones, better for the heart health, appropriate blood pressure, it will maintain the blood pressure, help for the pregnant woman, improve the blood circulation, better digestion, and keep the mind calmer. So these are the benefits of cluster bean. Production scenario. The global production during 2013-14 is 3 million metric ton. The global production is 3 million metric ton. The major world suppliers are India, Pakistan, and the United States, and the smaller acreage in Australia and Africa. The major suppliers are India, Pakistan, and United States, and smaller acreage it is grown in Australia and Africa. It is cultivated in north and northwest part of India. It is mainly grown in north part and northwest part of India. Total production during 2013-14 are 2.7 million metric ton. 2014-15 is 2,415,000 ton was produced from an area of 4,255,000 hectare, with an average productivity is 5.67 quintal per hectare. In India, the largest growing state is Rajasthan, with of total production is 82%. In India, it is mainly grown in Rajasthan. So Rajasthan is the major growing state, and it is grown 82% in Rajasthan, where it is cultivated as a rainfed crop. In Rajasthan, it is mainly grown in rainy season. So it is grown as a rainfed crop. Varieties, Goma Manjiri. Goma Manjiri, it is resistant to powdery mildew, bacterial wilt, and leaf spot. Pusa Moshami, it is suitable for rainy season and densely branching. First picking is 65 to 80 days and pods are 10 to 12 cm long. Pusa Moshami, suitable for rainy season. Pusa Sadabahar, it is a selection from local varieties of Jaipur, Rajasthan. It is suitable for summer and rainy season crop. Pusa Sadabahar, it is mainly suitable for the summer and rainy season. Both season it is grown. Sadabahar, single stem, non-branching, pods are 12 to 13 cm long, tender, fibreless. First picking is 40 to 45 days. National varieties of 40 to 45 days, national variety, very popular in India. So Pusa Sadabahar, it is mainly grown in all over the part. It is mainly grown in Rajasthan, and it is selection from the Jaipur, from Jaipur, Rajasthan only. Pusa Sadabahar. Cluster bean Pusa Navabahar. So these are the variety Pusa Navabahar. So it is also has a profuse flowering. Profuse fruiting is there. Pusa Navabahar. It is a cross between Pusa Moshami into Pusa Sadabahar. Pusa Moshami and Pusa Sadabahar cross. The single stem variety, pods are 15 cm of better quality. Pod size is 15 cm for the better quality. It is susceptible to bacterial blight and lodging. Lodging means the plant will be fall down. When the rains will come, so the plant is, the stem is very smooth and it will be fall down. So it is resistant to the lodging. P2811, smooth green, long pods, photosensitive, suitable for both season. P281, it is developed by the NBPGR. Pusa Navabahar into IC11521. It is suitable for both season. Sarat Bahar is a single plant selection from IC11704. Profuse branching, and it will produce the 133 pods. Gent type, the good quality seeds with high content of guar gum and grow in Rajasthan. It is mainly grown in Rajasthan. Dwarf type, the good quality pods used as a vegetable. It is mainly grown in Punjab and UP. IC11388. It is developed as a single plant selection from the local selection of Sukhpur in Kutch. Earlier than the Sarat Bahar, yield is 160 quintal per hectare. Next is Santa Cruz. Santa Cruz, it is a full season branching indeterminate globulus cultivars. It is mainly grown in USA and cultivated in high altitude. Climate. It is a tropical crop, preferred the warm season climate. It cannot tolerate to the shade and prefers the long day condition for vegetative growth and short day condition for the flowering. It required the long day condition for vegetative growth and short day condition for the flowering. The high tolerant to the temperature. Temperature is required 25 to 35 degree centigrade temperature is required. It can tolerant to drought and alkaline soil. It is also tolerant to the drought and alkaline soil. It is tolerant to the high temperature. Low precipitation and high temperature are required. It requires a low precipitation, high temperature. Next is soil. It is a shallow rooted crop with surface feeding nature. Shallow rooted crop means surface. The surface water is available, that only it will feed. Grow well under a wide range of soil condition. It is grow well into the different range of soils, but preferably it is grown in fertile, well-drained, medium textured and sandy loamy soil. Well-drained, medium texture and sandy loamy soil are the best. The pH of the soil is 7.5 to 8.5. Normally it is grown in neutral to alkaline soil pH. In heavy soil, the bacterial nodulation is hampered. If the heavy soil is there, the bacterial nodulation will be. Seed preparation. Selected seed must be free from the crop and weed seeds and disease. So whatever seeds we are selected is free from the crop seed and other crop seeds, weed seeds and disease. Inoculate the seeds before planting with a special guar inoculant or a cow pea inoculant like rhizobium. We have to inoculate the seeds in rhizobium before we will go for planting into the main field. The plant the seeds in moist soil within 2 hours after inoculation. Yes, after inoculation within 2 hours we have to plant the seeds into the field. Planting. The plant the guar when the soil temperature is over 21, means temperature is over 21 degrees centigrade. The optimum temperature for germination is 30 degrees centigrade. Temperature is optimum for the germination. Means the more than 21 degrees centigrade temperature is there, that time we will go for sowing of the guar, and if the temperature is 30 means it is best. Sowing time is, it is mainly the main season, the June, July, and in early crop it is grown in Feb to March. Main season, June, July, early crop, Feb to March. Spacing is 45 into 60 into 15 centimeter, means plant to plant 45 into 60 centimeter, and row to row 15 centimeter spacing we have to maintain. Seed rate is 25 to 30 kg per hectare. The seed rate required is 25 to 30 kg per hectare. The planting depth is 1 to 1.5 inches deep. Means when we sow the seeds, we will sow the seeds 1 to 1.5 inch deep. Fertilizer. So a hardy legume cluster bean respond to the fertilizer application. It is a hardy crop, so it will respond to the fertilizers. In addition to 25 ton of farmyard manure, we have to apply the 50-60-60 NPK per kg per hectare. 50-60-60 kg NPK per hectare we have to apply with 25 ton of FIM. Half dose of nitrogen, full dose of P and K are applied as a basal dose. Half dose of nitrogen and full dose of P is applied and K are applied as a basal dose. Remaining nitrogen is applied 15 to 30 days after. So, means we apply the nitrogen in two speed dose. First dose of nitrogen we apply during the land preparation. Means when we apply the P and K, with that only we apply the first dose of nitrogen. The remaining half dose of nitrogen we apply 25 to 30 days after sowing of the seeds. So a hardy crop, the irrigation increase the yield. It is a hardy crop, so if we apply the continuously water, so it will increase the yield. Irrigation of flowering and fruiting stage is most critical. So these are the critical stages of irrigation is flowering and fruiting state. For getting the high yield in vegetative type, the irrigation may be done 5 days interval. So every 5 days interval we will go for irrigation, so that we will get the more vegetative production, more vegetative yield we will get building. Because of the shallow growing, the rate of young guar plant, because we are already told is a shallow rooted crop is there, so weeding is very important. So because whatever the fertilizers are applied, that is on surface of the plant, surface of the soil only, and the weeds grow means they will take that nutrients, it will not available to the plants. So weed control, normally we can go for predominant weed is Parthenium. Parthenium is a major weed in guar. So spray the 2,4-D or DSME, disodium methane azoxanate, each 2 kg per hectare to control the Parthenium weed. So staking is also very important. Staking is also necessary to avoid the lodging of the tall plant. So normally it is a tall plant. So if we not give staking, the plant will be fall down. So to control that, we will give the staking to the plants. Harvesting. The crop duration is 120 days. The green pods are ready for harvesting in 45 days after sowing. The harvesting is, the crop duration is 120 days and the crop is ready. The pods are ready for harvesting in 45 days after sowing. The spray the triple C 2000 ppm, it will increase the yield, and the sodium molybdate 0.15% at 50th or 30th days after seedling emergence. So we will spray the triple C. Cycosil 2000 ppm, it will increase the yield. To increase the yield, we will spray the cycosil, and sodium molybdate we can spray 0.15%. It will spray, we will spray in 15 to 30 days for seedling emergence. Seed pods are brown and dry at maturity. Means pods color will change to the brown color and they will start drying after maturity. To speed up the drying and to kill the weeds, we can use the paraquat. Paraquat is mainly used to control the weeds. The dry seeds are harvested when a large percentage of pods are fully and most of the remaining will turn into the yellow color. So when the pods are turned into the yellow color, that time we will go for harvesting. It is observed that harvesting before the lower pods are dry enough to start setting. Means the when the pods will start setting, before that we will go for harvesting of the seeds. Yield is, green pod yield is 5 to 8 ton per hectare and the seed yield is 0.6 to 1 quintal per hectare. 0.6 to 1 quintal per hectare. Disease. The major disease of cluster beans are powdery mildew. It is caused by Levulella torica. It is a white powdery growth appears on the leaf upper surface, which hinders the photosynthesis. Means normally in upper surface of the leaf, the white powdery growth will come. So like this, the white powdery growth will come on the upper surface of the leaf, then the photosynthesis activity will be there. Means the light will not available to, means the color is changed to the white. So green color is there, then only the photosynthesis will be continued. And it will also affect the pods. If photosynthesis is not there, then the food will not available to the pods, and the pods will not develop properly. To control the, spray the crop with wettable sulfur, 3 gram per liter of water, or DynCap, 1 ml per liter of water when powdery growth is appeared. When the powdery mildew is there, that time we can use the wettable sulfur we can use. Phytophthora pod rot. Phytophthora pod rot, it is caused by the Phytophthora species. The roots show the rotting and griddling symptoms. You can see the rotting and griddling symptoms. The fruits show the rotting symptoms with white powdery fungal growth. Since the white powdery fungal growth will also come, and the plant will show the rotting symptom. You can see this plant. To control this, we can spray the Redomil MZ 0.25% on the appearance of the disease and repeat after 15 days. So we can spray the Redomil MZ to control the disease of Phytophthora. The little red yellow pustules will be appears on the leaves and the stems as well as the pods, and the pod production will be reduced. To control this, we can use the प्रोपेकोनाजोल वी कैन यूज. नेक्स्ट इज बैक्टीरियल ब्लाइट. इट इज कॉज्ड बाय द जेंथोमोनास साइमोप्सिडिकोला. जेंथोमोनास साइमोप्सिडिकोला. द प्लांट विल शो द सडन विल्टिंग इन हाई टेम्परेचर. ब्लाइट मीन्स द प्लांट विल शो द विल्टिंग सिम्टम्स. सो द विल्टिंग ऑफ द प्लांट्स विल बी स्टार्ट वेन द टेम्परेचर विल बी इंक्रीज एंड द पोड प्रोडक्शन विल बी रिड्यूस. If the plant will start wilting, then the production of the pod will be reduced. To control this, we can go over hot water treatment of seeds 56 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes. To control the bacterial blight, we can go for hot water treatment with 56 degrees Celsius temperature for 10 minutes. Ensure the proper drainage. Spray the streptocycline 150 ppm and agaramycin 100 to 500 ppm. So these we can spray. Either we can go for the streptomycin or we can go for agaramycin 100 to 150 ppm to control the bacterial blight. So in blight also the wilting symptoms will appear. Next is mosaic disease. So mosaic disease, the mosaic pattern appears on the leaves and the stem. Poor quality pores will be formed. Mosaic color appearance will come on the plant and the stems, and the poor quality pods will develop. To control this, the insect like aphid to prevent the spread of disease. So mosaic is spread by the aphid, so it is spread by the insect. So we have to control the insect. So the, for that we can use the insecticides we can use. The spray the aqueous leaf extract of pseudoanthron bicolor provokes the synthesis of viral inhibitors. So viral disease we can control by the different method. Cultural method we can use, like yellow sticky traps we can use, water traps we can use, we can grow the resistance varieties, we can use the neem seed kernel extract, we can control the insect attack by use of insecticides. Anthracnose, it is caused by the colletotrichum. The small angular brown spots appears on the leaves and the first deteriorating the pod quality. So in colletotrichum anthracnose, the brown spots will appear on the leaf and the fruits will start deteriorate and it will reduce the pod quality. So anthracnose, the quality of the pods will be reduced. To control this, we can go for spray the mancozeb 2%. So mancozeb 2% is effective to control the anthracnose. Insect pest. So insect pest like pod borer, aphid and plant hoppers. To spray the, to control this, we can go for phosphomidone 0.5 ml per liter of water, monocrotophos 1.25 ml per liter of water on appearance of the aphid. The spray the melathion 2 ml per liter of water, carbaryl 2 gram per liter of water 6 weeks after sowing can prevent the preventive measure. So insect pest means insect, they will spread the disease like aphid, pod borer means they will spread the disease. So to aphid will mainly spread the viral disease, and viral disease is very difficult to control. We can't control the viral disease. Only preventive measures we have to take to control the viral disease. So preventive options we can take, like we can grow the resistant varieties. We can control the insects by use of the yellow sticky traps. We can use the yellow sticky traps to control the insect population, or we can use the any other methods like yellow sticky traps. And we can use the neem seed kernel extract, we can use neem oil, we can use nemazole, we can use, and we can develop the resistance variety. So these are the methods we can use to control the viral disease. So if there is attack of any viral disease in the field condition, so just we take that plant and we can burn the plant. That is the only good choice to control the viral disease. So this is all about the cluster bean. Thank you all.